This was my father's generation. 70-hour work weeks, 350 feet deep in the belly of the earth. 40 years old, come up out of the mines with black lung, dying. Nothing to leave their families. There was no health care benefits. There was no retirement. 70-hour work weeks with no overtime, no child labor laws, kids going to work in the mines when they're 12 years old, no safety standards, until the United Mine Workers of America came to our area and organized those mines. We didn't have a quality of life. You load 16 tons and what do you get? Another day older and you're deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me? I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Those weren't just words of a song. That was life itself for my dad's generation. I know how important unions are. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Democrats, when America was at its height of prosperity, when no one rivaled us economically anywhere in the world, over 40% of the workforce of this country was union. Businesses made a good profit. The middle class was built on union wages. That's why it's important. When we hear the governor of this state say he wants to reduce us to minimum wage or no wage at all, don't hide in the corner and whisper you're a Democrat. Stand on the rooftop, shout that you're a Democrat, and be dadgum proud of it. We should be supporting our unions. How many times as a kid did I hear my poor father, who only had one arm and worked on the WDA as a water boy under the Roosevelt administration? They say, Ezra, what do you do for a living? And my dad would kind of look at his feet and shuffle his feet and say, oh, I'm just a hired hand. Until the unions organized in this country, whether it was in the steel mills, in the garment factories, in the schoolrooms, in the government working offices, until the unions organized, we were all just hired hands. But when they did organize, those old hired hands became productive hands, they became profitable hands, and they became safer hands. And we owe that to the union brothers and sisters in America. God love them is what I say. Fourth great value of our party, equal justice for every citizen under the law. Equal justice. It does not matter what our race is, what our ethnicity is, what our religion is, what our sexual orientation is. None of those things matter. When we come before the court of jurisprudence in America, we must be equal under the law. Justice Harlan said at the turn of the century that American justice must be colorblind. And we know that. That's why, Democrats, we have to go all the way down to the bottom of the ballot to seek out those Democratic judges that you know stand for integrity and upon this great principle of equality under the law. Because listen, our president has already offered up to the U.S. Senate a moderate Republican to take the place of Justice Scalia. And what happened? They wouldn't even give him a hearing. So what kind of justice do you think that Donald Trump is going to appoint to the U.S. Supreme Court? A justice so far right that no law of human rights or civil rights will be secure in this country. So don't let it happen. Find those judges. Go down the ballot and vote for the Democrat judge that you know that will stand for this great principle. Last principle, and I will end. The fifth great principle upon which we have always stood as Democrats is to protect the most vulnerable among us. President Kennedy said, if a free society cannot help the many who are poor, it cannot hope to save the few who are rich. That is so true. And why is that important to us? Because it spells out who we are as Americans. It talks about our heart of giving, of protecting the least among us. Hubert Humphrey put it this way. He said, the real test of a free democratic people is how we treat those in the dawn of their lives, our children, those in the dusk of their lives, our elderly, and those in the shadows of life, our disabled, our dispossessed, our disenfranchised. That is the true test of America. My wife and I have run an organization, a foundation to protect abused, neglected, and abandoned children for 17 years. This past year, this governor cut off all the funds for counseling these abused, neglected, and abandoned children. Is that what they believe? Is that what we've come down to in expecting our government to treat the most disabled, disenfranchised among us this way? It isn't America. It isn't this state. It isn't being a Democrat. So thank you for having me here. I want to remind you, balance the budget. Don't borrow and spend on the back of our children. Protect the most vulnerable among us. Equal educational opportunities for all of our children. Stand up for our union brothers and sisters and equal justice under the law. That's who we are as Democrats. God love you. Thank you.